Well Beyond curriculum is really poised to continue the leadership of the Jacobs School. As one of the first schools in the country, founded in 1846, we really want to make sure that we're delivering the care to the patients right where they need it. One of the things we want our students to do is to be able to take data and science and what they learn from the patient and make a care plan.
There's no doubt that to be a great physician, you have to have a lot of knowledge about science, about medicine. If you don't understand a person's background and you don't understand what their struggles may have been, you're not going to be able to use any of your interventions.
Patients aren't just looking for a prescription. They're looking for a connection. They're looking for their doctor to understand them. They're looking to be seen and understood. And when that connection happens, that is where real change is possible.
The Well Beyond curriculum is a deliberate walk in the direction of creating inclusive community.
It's not good enough for us to just talk the talk. It's really important for us to be a part of the solution, to make our community more healthy as we train the next generation of physicians.
I think we really need a new way to be able to teach students because they can't know everything the moment they get out of medical school. They have to continue that process and they have to continue to learn.
Being a lifelong learner is critical to being a good doctor. And first and foremost, we want to graduate good doctors that use all the tools at their disposal.
The volume and the pace of information change is enormous now. And so you need to be able to learn how to go through this enormous body of knowledge.
Practice for practice means students have an opportunity to engage in experiences that will prep them for being able to be in practice, but do it in an active way.
Getting those experiences happening early are really, really critical. And I think that's a real important part of just forming that identity of being a physician.
As a part of our academic health center, we have all of these health profession schools. We have pharmacy, we have dentistry, we have nursing, we have social work, we have public health. All of these schools together work in an interdisciplinary way to show us how interprofessional education works, how to build teams, how to work across disciplines to provide the best patient care.
We've really created a true medical campus, and the building itself and the structure, there's something tangible about being on a medical campus, that feeling of being at the forefront and being able to work with leading edge technology.
We have had great support from our leadership all along for supporting our students. We have our educational success program, which is one that has a three-tiered approach. In that approach, we have sessions that are incorporated within the curriculum to help students understand how they learn, what are some of the most effective learning strategies, and how do they apply them within their studies based on where they are.
Our learning communities will help students get through this experience of a medical training in a way that provides them support and gives them a chance to get to know a small group of students that will be their peers for years, and also a coach who will be there to see them through all of these years.
Well Beyond curriculum is helping students develop the skills to understand that medicine is about learning for the rest of their career and the rest of their lives. Well, this idea of building the spirit of inquiry that starts with us as individuals, but then it also means sharing things with our teammates, and it means if we're asking doctors to also be leaders in the community, how are we training them to connect with the community that's beyond the Jacobs four walls?
You can't just come to medical school and go to class. You also are encouraged to become active in this medical school, to establish relationships, to build friendships, to learn things about others, and then not just to learn, but to value those things.
To be an agent of change, you have to understand
what you're trying to change.
We have to look beyond ourselves, but also be future-oriented, that we can't sort of stay stuck in what's happening right now. We have to look beyond ourselves.